Well, here we are again after a bit of a pause. As you can see, a new version of the MegaIC Tester. It's in a bigger case because we've now got the new switch and the power protection board installed. So the ZIF socket is now horizontal rather than vertical. We've got these isolation switches that allow us to disconnect individual pins from the Arduino. We've got ground, 5 volts. A stepping output, a two-step input. We've now got a power light that says when the ZIF socket is powered, and we've got our test light. The screen's just the same. I've done some additional mods to the software, so let's have a quick look at it. Okay, the first thing we're going to do is we're going to pop in a 4020 IC. Make sure all the switches are set. There we go. We'll do an identify. 16-pin chip. This is all the same as it was before. So it's found it as a 4020. We can pick that. And it's a 14-bit async binary counter with reset. So it's given that a good test. We've got the timing diagram which I showed you the last time round. oops, I could have gone into the test mode there easily enough, but anyway. So we'll do test on 4020. As you can see, the ZIF power lights come on now that it's actually testing the chip. Okay, we'll go into exercise mode. And the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go into manual mode. So now, if you remember, in manual mode, I make changes to the inputs, and those changes are only actually applied to the chip when I press the test button. So at the moment we've got the reset line high, so if we do a test, then all the outputs stay low because we've reset the counter. So if we change the reset to off, press test again, there's no clock, so still nothing happens. If we put the clock into pulse mode, press test, the divide by 2 output goes up, and then it goes down, then it goes up. And you'll note the divide by 16 output is off at the moment. We're continuing to pulse the clock, and now the divide by 16 has gone high. We can keep on testing like that. Previously you could set up multiple tests in the database, but you couldn't do manual multiple tests, but now I've implemented that. So if we go back to init, so the reset line is high, we'll do a next, right, the reset line is off, and we can now go back into manual mode and we'll say that we want to pulse the counter, and this time we've also got the multiple button, so we can press mult, and we can now set up a multiple test where the inputs, which in this case are just reset and the clock and pulse, are going to be varied based on the number of counts that we implement. So down here we've got, this is how many tests we're going to implement, which is 1. We've got a plus and a minus sign. We can increment the count by 1 just by pressing the plus button. Right, we can then press the increment counter value, so that's 10, 100, 1000 and 10,000. So it's very easy to change the number of counts that we want to implement on the chip. So that's 4. So what we'll do is we'll do 127, I think. There we go. Now this button is an S, so that's showing that the count, test will start in slow mode. But we can poke that, and it'll go to fast mode, or we can poke it again, and it'll go back to slow mode. So if we start the test 127 times, a clock pulse, and we hit the test button, and there we go. There's the 2 going up and down, 16's going up and down, 32's going up and down. We've got the thing up the top here that shows we're in slow mode. If we want to flip to fast mode, we can do that easily enough. Right, so that's finished. So because we've counted from 0 up to 127, the divide by 64, 32, and 128, and 16, and slash 2 are all high. Now the 128's high, because it goes high after the on the 64th count or over, and then it will go low once we do another pulse. So we'll just check that. So the count's gone back to 1, and if we do a test, they all go low, and the divide by 256 now goes high, and it will then go low once we get to 256. Now we've got 1 back in here, and it's easy to switch back to the last value we entered just by pressing that, or we can go back to 1 again. So that's how I've implemented the multiple test capability in manual mode. So I've now got a 4026 IC in the socket. I've got a breadboard here with a 7-segment LED display on it, some current limiting resistors, the appropriate wiring, and it's wired back to the appropriate outputs from the 4026. I've opened the switches on all of the pins that are going to drive the LED to make sure that we don't overload the chip by having the Arduino and the LED connected. And we can now go in and do a test on the 4026. And if you watch the LED display, as the test is run, it, the test specifies that it counts up from 0 to 9, I think. So hit that. So there we go. And it says it's failed, and that's just because, as I say, we've disconnected the pins. But we can now go into exercise mode. We can step through individual test cases, backwards or forwards, as we wish. Or we can go into manual mode. And tell you what, let's go into let's do a reset. Let's put it back into down to 0. We'll take the reset off, leave the clock on, and we'll go into a multiple test, and let's run from 0 up to 100. Now obviously this is only a single digit, so we're only going to see it count up a number of times. I'll tell you what, that's 101, so we'll just take it down to 100, run the test, and away it goes. Right, and then we can flip into fast mode. That's it, done. So that's showing you how we can drive external circuitry from the MegaIC tester. So this is the new case. It's printed with white lettering, which I've done just by printing 2 layers of the front in black, then 2 layers in white, and then the rest of the front is printed in black. Easily enough, pop it off. The insides of the tester. There's the inside of the cover. As I say, it's got a nice white pinstripe down the side as the where we've done the layering for the lettering. Here's the display. Here's my new printed circuit board that I got made. This is the second version. I made some schoolboy errors on the first one. Now you might notice this is what you might think of as some bodge wires here, which are connected to the SDA and SCL I2C lines, and to the positive and to the negative. So I'll show you what they're for in a second. So if we pop out the display board, and we'll pop out the main board. Okay. So under here, as well as the Arduino, we've also got a DS2321 real-time clock module. And what that's for is I wanted to utilize the I wanted to be able to utilize the IC tester even when it wasn't being used as an IC tester. So I want to be able to use it as a clock. So if we just reassemble this, show you how the clock looks. So I've implemented the clock in the style of the Apollo guidance computer DSKY display. So I've now got an AGC DSKY button instead of whatever was on there before, I can't remember. Now I'm just gonna download a new version of the firmware onto the MegaIC tester, because I currently don't I haven't implemented the I've implemented the AGC DSKY separately and haven't merged it with the MegaIC code, MegaIC tester code. So I'll just download the AGC DSKY code and then show you what that looks like. Okay, so to implement the AGC DSKY, I wanted to be able to have the IC tester on its side, so it's nice and easy to get the power in. So if we just get that out of the glare, plug the power in. Okay, so here's the DSKY display. We're in standby mode and we've just had a computer restart. And there we go. So there's my AGC DSKY clock. Even though it looks like a DSKY display, at the top here I've got degrees C because it's using the temperature sensor on the DS real-time clock module. We've got the month, we've got the day, we've got the year, hours, minutes and seconds. Now, I am implementing some other AGC functions just for the fun of it, but they may not be able to sit in the memory alongside the MegaIC tester, so this might be all as far as I go with the AGC implemented in parallel with the MegaIC tester. I've also implemented the DSKY keyboard, right, so you'll be able to enter verbs and nouns. And I've also done some demonstrations where we go through parts of the moon landing, that sort of thing. Anyway, that's where we're at. Hope you like it. See you next time. Bye.